Hey, how's it going? I saw your message really late.
That's okay. Hi, Elizabeth. Wow.
Hi.
I'm so glad you're there, Sean. That's really great. Oh, hi.
I'm just popping in to say hello.
Nice to see you. I'm so glad you came. Is Christopher there too?
Yeah.
He's sitting resting on the couch.
Oh, say hi to him for me.
Christopher, do you want to come say hi to Miss Carla? Come on over here so she
can. He's tall.
Oh, hi.
Oh, my God, he's so tall.
Nice to see you.
I knew I recognized you.
Yeah.
And I'm otherwise known as Chris Marshall's mom.
Yeah, that's Chris Marshall's mom there.
Marshall's mom.
thanks for saying hi.
Yeah. I was going to say, like, if you want this to be a sing-along, that's not going to work.
we've been doing this for weeks.
But people can. What
we usually do is one person sings a song and the rest of the people are muted. Except for once in a while, we'll do a song like, I Love My Rooster, and then like one person will sing, but then when it's the time for the noises, everyone will make noises.
Right, yeah, okay, yeah, I just...
So like what we can do for the first rock song is...
We're kind of limited by the speed of light. Okay.
I'm so glad you're there. We have to wait a while.
I had a little piece of work that I needed to do this morning. If I hadn't had to do that, I probably wouldn't have read my email. So,
well, I'm glad you're there. I'm just going to turn on another light over here because it's kind of dark. I'm going to put on headphones too, so it's a little bit. There, that's better. Yeah, because I'm in Belgium, so it's like 10 o'clock at night here.
You know, I thought on the invite you were going to say, like, the 9th of August at roughly 1 o'clock.
Like, yeah, well, I did say that at on the Facebook group. I did say that, yeah. Sorry, I didn't say that on the email, but I said it on the Facebook at roughly 1 o'clock. Hi, Julie.
Hi, Carla. How are you?
Fine. Julie, were you there at the Fortress Rock Fire?
No, it wasn't during camp, was it?
It was, well, it was second session. Maybe you were first.
I never went second session.
Oh, okay. That's why.
Yeah. No, I wasn't. I only heard about it.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel sorry for all the first session people. They didn't, you know, get to...
Except that August is too hot, so it's okay.
I was there, I just don't remember it.
How old were you then? You were a kid. You were a, were you a baby or were you
one.
Not born?
I'm one.
Oh, you were one. Okay.
Yeah, that was my first summer that I was there, like all summer. I can see.
Wow. And you guys lived in Traderhorn. Did you live in Traderhorn?
I thought so, but I mean, I don't remember anything until being there until I'm about five.
Oh, yeah.
Huh. I remember six really clearly because I cut my tongue fairly badly, actually. I still have a little bump where that happened, but I fell off the craft shop porch there and... Almost, yeah, I mean, took a chunk out of my tongue. It was really painful. Mm-hmm. But I remember I got a lot of ice cream, so that's good.
Oh, that's good, yeah. That's really good. Julia, you're working on some project there. You're sewing something, or? Oh, wow.
Well, I have a needlepoint project in my head, but I don't know how to needlepoint. So I'm learning. That's what I'm doing. it might be good to know how to do it before I launch into this big project. Ooh, I'll show you when I'm going to do my needlepoint project. You're going to like this, Carla.
Okay. Wow. Yeah. Wait, Julie, is that a project that you're going to needlepoint that? Is that weird?
Yeah, I'm going to figure out how to transfer this picture onto this picture of Mount Rainier and the wildflowers. It's hard to see on the video, but Mount Rainier and the wildflowers, I'm going to figure out somehow how to transfer it onto a needlepoint thing and then do a needlepoint of it someday.
Was that picture from Paradise, or where was it?
I don't know. I bought it when I was, you know, climbing Mount Rainier, and I was in a shop. So, but it's very beautiful, and it needs to be a needlepoint someday.
Hi, so, Mom and Dad. Hi, Bill and Morty. Hi. Hi, Robin. Hi, Lynn. Hi, Darcy.
Hello. Hey.
Mom and Dad, the one whose name says Christopher, that's Sean Lamont.
No. Hi, Sean.
Hey.
Are you Christopher?
Christopher is his son, so I guess he's like using his son's device or something, but he's that's Sean.
Actually, he named my Zoom is basically what it's about.
How's everybody doing? Yeah, Darcy, wait, was it you that said you might not be here, or that was...
I wasn't expecting to be, but my mom's doing okay, and I got her all set up, and so I came home a day early.
All right.
So, yeah, worked out. How's everybody? Happy 4th Conflagration Day.
Yeah.
It's amazing to me that it's not only is it 50 years, but it's also a Sunday. Right? I mean, it's just kind of, it's kind of perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, and the weather, it's clear.
Well, it depends on where you are. It's not so clear here, but not clear there.
It's pretty good here today. It's better than yesterday.
But I was thinking, because this 1970 was my first year at camp, but I only went first session that first, so I missed it.
Darcy, me too. That was my first year and I only went first session.
Wait, who's talking?
That was Julie.
Julie.
Oh, okay.
Hi.
Hi, Liz.
Yeah.
It was also, this is Sean, it was also my first year at camp, but I was only one, so.
Right. So you probably don't remember your dad writing it, do you?
Oh, I remember him singing it because he's sung it for years, but I don't remember that particular time, you know?
Yeah,
There's pictures of me just sort of looking around days or running around days.
Hi, Z.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Z.
Wow, we are getting more and more people who actually were there.
There we go.
All right.
Z, were you there when Fortress Rock caught fire?
What was it, 1970?
It was 1970.
Buzz.
Were you? Cool.
Yes, I was there the summer of 1970, although I kept wondering maybe I was on a camp out or something. I don't really remember all the rockets.
Right.
But that could be old age.
Well, apparently the ruckus was much less than Tim recorded for posterity's sake.
I see.
Well, that's the point of the grand song of remembrance is that it's just completely exaggerated, right?
Yes, exactly.
I'm not heroic.
Yeah, he used poetic license to, you know, like when it said the weakest of our number decided they would drown. Actually, they decided to go cliff diving because that was an activity that people did off of Fortress Rock in those days.
Well, I don't know if it was ever actually a sanctioned activity. We did it.
We did it. Did you ever do it? Did you ever do it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We used to, when we'd have nose bags out there, we'd always go off the backside. There was a little cliff.
Hi, Megan.
Hi.
Hello. Hi, baby.
Megan, long time no see.
I know.
So does anyone, can anyone explain what's going on with this reunion, virtual reunion thing? It's only an hour and a half long. It was going to be 3 days and now it's only an hour and a half.
Yeah. Megan, you want to take that?
Yeah, we're definitely going a different direction, but I think it'll be fun. We'll have, we'll roll out some surprises. There'll be a trivia contest. There will be some live components, some pre-recorded components. There will be some raffle items to be won. Sorry, I'm still sweaty from my walk. So it'll be fun. It's going to be short. It's not the same as gathering, but maybe at least we can gather some people from further away.
So. Yeah, that's true.
And we're hoping that next year, maybe we can do the real thing again. We'll just make it the 86.
Right. COVID willing. That's my new saying.
Exactly. That's right.
Yeah.
Well, however possible, however possible it is to make something like a Zoom call like epic, just trust that it's going to be as epic as we can make it, because everybody's been working super, super hard on it. So it's going to be great. And help spread the word, everybody. Let's get everybody on there. It's not going to be on a Zoom platform per se, so we don't have to worry about bandwidth. But it's going to be great. It's going to be awesome.
When is it?
We should really know that off the top of our heads.
August 29th
at 1 Pacific.
1 Pacific okay. time. Yep, August 29th.
So, Bailey, is it going to be recorded so that if people can't make it at that time, they can watch it later?
Yeah, we think so. We expect so. Okay. They're still working out. So we're going to work. We're working with Kirkland Performing Arts Center, who do some, like, have the facilities sort of put together the pre-recorded stuff and the live stuff. And they're meeting next week. So we should know a little bit more about, you know, it'll be probably a YouTube link or a WebEx or a Vimeo link, and then we'll have a recording hopefully right after.
Cool.
I'll have you guys know, my friend really wanted to go to a dog agility trial that weekend, and I said, nope.
Good.
I'm busy.
That's not a good idea.
Yeah. Well, that's cool. It's still so strange to me that camp is in any way at all involved with virtual anything.
Yeah. They really tried to make the summer stuff kind of a mix, and you know, we definitely agree, like, camp is not digital.
Yeah. So. Yeah, I mean, just even the fact that there's a web page, you know, it just still kind of mind, you know.
Hi, four of us.
Hi, Corey.
Four of us were in Camilla's meeting link. So I just went, guys, no one else is showing up. Something's wrong. So then we looked and there was an email from Carla. Sorry, everybody.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Who was it about the conflagration and what it was like?
Yep,
hi, Steve. Yeah. Hi, everybody. Sorry about that. There comes Jim. Yeah. So we've been sitting there talking about it, and someone is going to show off her silkscreen.
Oh.
Yeah,
Oh.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about. Isn't that the coolest?
Wow, how come it's so big?
Because it's just a virtual background.
Oh, okay.
I think that's awesome. Anyway, sorry for the lateness. We were lame.
Say what?
Sorry for the lame lateness, but we're here now.
No, this was a laundry bag because I didn't have a shirt to put it on that year, so I just gave them what I had.
That's perfect. And my dad had that on his VW Bug, right? So he had it, like, we 50 something VW Bug, and he had painted it on the side, and we found that people would move out of our way when they saw it come. Hilarious.
Hi, Richard.
Hi.
Rich is here. Hey.
Yay. I'm so happy to see you, April. Thank you for sending the song out so that we could all be united in weirdness.
Yes. So is Carolyn Gould the same as Ellen Gould now?
Carolyn is Ellen's mother and my mother.
Oh, okay.
Ellen and I are sisters.
Yeah, I knew that, but I
just Carolyn's our mother, and she went to Henderson camps. And Carl Presley is my uncle, Carolyn's brother, and Susie Presley and Alan Presley are my cousins.
Hi, okay. Sue.
Hi, Sue.
I'm late, everybody.
Oh, great.
Wow, nice to see everybody. This is really a old time reunion. I wonder if any of those youngsters are going to come. There have been some, like, people who were just troubadours and mountaineers last summer, so they're...
Oh, it's been great to have the kids.
Great, yeah.
The kids.
Yeah, I think sure Robin's representing the youth right now.
Just me here, yep.
You are the youth, Robin. How does that feel?
The youngins.
Well,
Elizabeth's pretty youthful, guys. Yeah. Come on now.
Just turned 27, so...
Okay.
Marching towards 30.
A wee spot.
Yeah, that's what you get for hanging out with the old crowd, you know.
Yeah. You get older. Yeah.
I would be willing to bet that I am the youngest person that was actually there.
Okay.
At the fire?
Deshaun, yes, probably.
Probably because Carla and I were 10 in 1970.
Right.
Were you
and
there
I was not allowed to go to the Rock being, you know, 10. So.
Oh. That's too bad.
We had to stand on shore and watch.
Yeah, we stood on shore and cheered and watched and picked up wampum and danced and did crazy things for hours. It was super fun.
Yeah. Richard, were you there? Were you first session or second session?
I was second session. I was there. And my claim to fame is that my unit went out and volunteered to go to Fortress Rock. And Peggy Bill said, "No, you're just a bunch of kids who want to go out and play. You can't go there."
And you're like, "Yes, we are." Oh, that's so funny. Well, you tried.
What unit were you, Rich?
Rangers.
And my understanding, I haven't talked to Tex today, but I think he would say that the song came about because everybody was arguing over it, and people were mad at each other. Is anybody else have that understanding?
Yeah, I remember there was a conflagration about the conflagration or the lack of conflagration. So they decided to make this hilarious song about it so that we could all laugh together and stop being poop heads.
Yeah, that's my understanding.
Me too. That was my, don't you think so, Elaine? I mean, that's what I remember.
Yeah, there was a lot of, you can't go there, but, you know, do this kind of thing.
Yeah, there was a lot of madness, but it was, you know, I mean, it was a rock and there was some burning moss. I mean, it's, you know.
Hence the subject for a ballad.
And a whaler that would only go.
It almost burned up. It was almost not there. What are you talking about?
I know, it's totally scary. Yeah.
And a whaler that would only go in reverse.
Yes.
That cracks me up. I can just imagine Lyle driving the whaler backwards.
It was special.
I gotta say the video that Katie recently sent of Lyle describing events and going in reverse just was bittersweet and amazing and perfect. It was so good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
Telling the story as only Lyle could.
Yeah.
So are we gonna sing it?
Well, yeah. We might have critical mass. It's 17 minutes past the hour. What do you think, guys? Shall we give it a go?
We could sing it at the beginning and at the end.
Perfect.
Then if more people come along, they still get it.
I mean, but do it continuously as a round and then people come in and out.
Well, what we've discovered on these Zooms, for those that haven't been here every single week, is that it's easier if one person sings and we mute and sing along, rather than having the cacophony of, you know, Belgium talking to New York, talking to, you know, if that's
yeah, we're
okay
limited
with you
by
the
speak light, unfortunately.
We could,
this might be one where each person does a verse.
We could do that. I have
since
to call
so
it
many
up.
Verses.
We could.
Because we all remember the words so well.
Oh, yeah. It's a classic of our time.
I have to reference the book unless I'm on the first one.
Or we could all sing the chorus together.
No,
there were counselors on. Yeah.
It's still going to be a cacophony if we do that.
It will. It will so be a cacophony. Well, okay. Who would like to, Rich, are you? Carla, are you?
I think we should get Sean. I think we should get Sean to sing it.
I think that'd be awesome.
Okay, I'm going to mute everybody, and then we'll like unmute for the last chorus or something. And when we can sing it again later, too. We can all sing it. I'm going to mute all. I'm going to mute all, and I'm going to unmute. We have to unmute. I cannot get Sean to unmute. Sean can unmute.
People have to unmute themselves.
Okay, I'm going to mute all, and Sean, unmute yourself.
I think I'm on. That work?
Yeah.
Okay. So, am I gonna like? God, I'm gonna have to find the lyrics. Do you have the lyrics?
They are posted on. Maybe we need another leader. They are posted on the Norwester Legacy site. Carla put them up there. So if you go to Facebook, you can call it up.
I have them somewhere. Obviously, I just don't. I don't know exactly where.
Okay.
Probably in my garage.
How about Richard? Richard, do you have the words? Richard, do you want to start off leading us on this? Doesn't have the words.
You do, Carla. I'm seeing a guitar, Carla.
I can do the first verse and the chorus. That's about it. I mean, actually, I can muddle my way through it, but I don't have the words in front of me.
Oh, I have them, and I also know it by heart.
All right, Carla. That's it, girl. Everybody mute.
Okay. Sorry. I guess I'll do it. But I want to know, what's that thing, Sean, that you did with the chords that was different? Well, you can.
I don't know how I did it differently.
Okay.
I mean, if you did do it differently, I can tell you.
Okay. You can tell me after how I did it. Okay.
Hey, Carla, mute us all, please. Oh, okay. Thank you, my
trying,
friend.
Trying to do it.
Thank you.
Yes. Okay. Ready? 'Twas on the 9th of August, 1970 was the year. It was Sunday morning and the weather, it was clear. When one of our boat company at roughly 10 o'clock espied great fumes of billowing from the crest of Fortress Rock. We'd need counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, and unfatiguing crew of bold firefighters on the rock. He ran to tell his comrades that disaster might be nigh, and gathered up a scouting crew who didn't quite know why. But they climbed aboard the landing craft and departed from the dock. They lived to come and tell us of the fire upon the rock. We'd need counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, and unfatiguing crew of bold firefighters on the rock. They returned a short time later, and the leader, he did state that the flames were high and mighty, and we'd almost be too late. But a messenger, he spread the news, which was an awesome shock. We'd need a crew of fearless men and women on the rock. We'd need counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, and unfatiguing crew of bold firefighters on the rock. When once we landed at the rock, we all did spring ashore, and we set up a pump and hose for a quarter hour or more. But alas, the equipment failed us, and so tense we could not talk. We organized a bucket crew to douse that flaming rock. There were counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, and unfatiguing crew, bold firefighters on the rock. The flames, they leapt around us, but not a man did flinch. The smoke, it threatened life and health, but no one moved an inch. Untiringly, we manned our post so steep we dared not walk, and kept that awful fire from consuming all the rock. There were counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, and unfatiguing crew of bold firefighters on the rock. And finally it was over, at least we thought it so. We trudged our weary bodies down and back to Shorted Row. But several hours later, approaching 3 o'clock, the scouting crew reported two more fires on the rock. There were counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, an unfatiguing crew of old firefighters on the rock. Our brave, undaunted band arose without a grumbling sound and steered our dreadful course again for that enchanted ground. With steadfast resolution, the flames and smoke we'd stop and tried to keep our sanity while toiling on the rock. There were counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, an unfatiguing crew of old firefighters on the rock. And when at last we'd finished 3,000 buckets down, the weakest of our number decided they would drown. They'd rather face a cruel death whose meaning we might mock than spend another horrid hour toiling on the rock. There were counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, an unfatiguing crew of old firefighters on the rock. They gathered at the cliffside and over they did go, and they all were swept out seaward by the dreaded undertow. But the landing craft approached them, and despite its engine's knock, it slowly brought those shattered few back home from off the rock. There were counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, an unfatiguing crew of old firefighters on the rock. Okay, here it comes. Well, many years have come and gone, all since that fateful day, but we all recall it vividly. There's none of us who'd say he'd e'er see more excitement, or souls would dearly flock to join the crew who saved us all from death on Fortress Rock. There were counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, and unfatiguing crew of bold firefighters on the rock.
Okay, in unison, I'm gonna unmute everybody. We'll sing it on, ready?
There were counselors on the rock, campers on the rock, and unfatiguing crew of bold firefighters
on the rock. Oh, so fun.
Wow.
Hi, Fred.
Oh, hi, Fred, wow. All right.
That was amazing, and Sean, I remember you were a teeny weeny weeny baby boy. You were like being worn on backs and stuff. Is that not correct? Oh, can't hear you, my friend.
Oh, is someone muted?
I remember you. Yeah, well,
in 1970, which was my first summer at camp, I was 18 months old.
Yes, an adorable toddler that everyone wanted to snuggle. You were so cute.
Yes.
I mean, all the women here, I'm right, right? I mean, he was the cutest thing ever.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I remember you were worn on daddy's back sometimes.
Mom's too.
And mama's too, yeah. Pretty amazing.
I think she did that. Better horn that year. I'm not sure. I know she did it 1 year.
Amazing. Amazing. Yeah. And what a legacy your family has given us all. So grateful for that. Yeah. Sure. I mean, think about it. Think of how all of the people that you're seeing here's lives were touched by your family. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I know. It is.
Yeah. And now that we have sung the great song, which we can sing again later if we want, perhaps someone else has a song, like Richard has a guitar poised with a
I see that
key chord under his fingers. Yes. So perhaps
he's sitting there all well lit with beautiful wood behind him, looking very Richard. It's awesome. We must have a song, mustn't we? Mustn't we?
We must. Okay, I'm going to mute all and have Richard unmute himself. Unmute yourself. Thanks.
I've been thinking about this because I haven't been back for a while, that I would follow the example of my fearless leader and mentor, Z, who said to me not long ago, he shared a song that, if I'm putting this correctly, Z, you didn't sing at camp, but if you'd thought of it or if you'd known it, you would have. Carla knows this song, and if we weren't in different time zones, she could sing a great harmony to it. This is called I Drew My Ship. It's a Gordon Bach song. Oh, I will put my ship in order, and I will set it on the sea, and I will sail to yonder's harbor to see if my love mine's on me. I think I'm going to take it down a step. I drew my ship into the harbor. I drew it up where my true love lay. I drew it close by into her wind to listen what my love did say. Who's that who knocks loud at my window? Who knocks so loud and would come in? It is your true love who loves you dearly. Then rise, love, and let me in. So slowly, slowly got she up, and slowly, slowly came she down. But before she got the door unlocked, her true love had both come and gone. He's brisk and broad, he's far away, he's far beyond the raging main, where bright eyes glancing and fishes dancing have made him quite forget his own. Oh, I will put my ship in order, and I will set it on the sea, and I will sail to yonder's harbor to see if my love mine's on me.
All right.
Thank you so much, Rich. While you were singing, we were saying, the voice of camp childhood from Lynn. Yeah. I mean, seriously, a lot of us, that was the voice when we were kids, and it's just so wonderful to hear you sing. Thank you.
All right, who else is ready for giving us a song? Z?
Oh, Z, speaking of another voice of camp childhood that we totally patterned on as young people, just saying.
Okay. Let's see. Well, let's see. I think our current camp song or music director did the Tennessee Stud the other week. And correct me if I'm wrong, but is that still a current camp song?
Yes, indeed.
Okay, so apparently not everybody has heard the other version of that song, so I thought I'd do that. And it's, I'm not sure, Richard, that this one would be okay for camp, because it has political overtones at the end, and I don't know if we do that, you know. So anyway, so here's the, instead of the Tennessee Stud, here's the Idaho Spud.
Okay, hold on, I'm gonna mute everyone, and Z's gonna unmute himself. Okay. Z, do you see the unmute button? Z, you have to unmute yourself. Uh-oh.
Z. There we go.
Ah, thank you.
That would be good. Well, along about 1974, I left Sun Valley, was such a bore. Packed up my Ray-Bans and my Gucci duds, and I went off to work in the Idaho Spuds. Well, I rolled on down into Burley Town, found a nice young thing, kind of knobby and brown. I said, sweet thing, I'll dig you later, right now I'm looking for an Idaho tater. Well, the Idaho Spud was long and green, covered with butter and sour cream. Lay it on the ground and clean off the mud. There never was a tater like the Idaho Spud. Well, they eat the lobster on the coast of Maine and the Gila monster on the Texas plain. Real men down under eat the witchetty grub, but they all taste better with an Idaho Spud. You can make it into vodka, you can make it into beer, you can eat it with a chicken or an old dead steer. Stop her on a gas can or serve it at the club. You never was a tater like the Idaho Spud. Well, the Idaho Spud
was long,
covered with butter and sour cream. Just dig it from the ground and clean off the mud.
Mud. Never seen
the Idaho Spud. Okay, here comes the bad part. Well, there's nuclear waste on the desert floor, and the NRC wants to ship in more. Big hole in the ground, well, they're dumping their crud. Radioactive Idaho Spuds. There's a cute little mutant on the cabin floor, and another half kid to stop open the door. Daylight light up like green tomatoes, cause they're serving their youngins on nuclear taters. Well, the Idaho Spud was long and green, covered with butter and sour cream. Dig it from the ground, clean off the mud. There never was a tater like the Idaho Spud. Never was a tater like the Idaho Spud. That's it.
Yeah! So awesome! Thank you, Z. I love that.
Z, I don't think anti-nuke lyrics are too politically incorrect for camp.
I don't know. I mean, I think, Carla, aren't you running on nuclear power over there?
Yeah, that and other kinds of power too. There's wind, there's burned garbage steam produced power, there's some hydroelectric power, there's solar power, lots of people. Solar power.
Yeah, I just knew France was, still like 70% or something. Anyway, there was a plan to put a nuke plant in Idaho, and that was some, I don't know the name of the guy that wrote it, but that was what he came up with as a anti-nuke song.
Nothing like a good filk.
Yeah, that's right.
There was a plan to put one in the Skagit Valley too, which they changed.
Good times. Yeah.
Yeah.
Is Robin still with us? Oh, there
he is. Yeah, he is. He's very quiet. Robin, would you like to do a song? Corey would like you to do a song, it sounds like.
I would.
I don't have anything.
I'm not shy. I want Robin to sing a song. Anything that occurs to your brain that blips up that might just want to leave your face and come to us?
if you want, you can think about it while someone else who might already have one in mind does theirs.
Yeah.
Fred, how are you?
I got a song, but I got a tune, so.
Okay. Looks like Robin's tuning. Does someone want to sing while Robin's tuning?
I can do one, but I haven't thought about what. So I don't know. If
Robin is kind of the king of tuning, really. He's like,
yeah,
the
maybe he would just turn on his mic and let us hear him tuning.
We like to hear you tune, Robin. It's kind of fun.
Yeah, I'll mute everyone and Robin can tune, can give us some.
It really takes us back to the lodge, you know, those moments where we were watching someone tune and going, this is going to be amazing.
Okay, Robin, they're all muted. You can just unmute them.
Well, seeing Rich reminded me of one of my favorite songs that you actually taught me how to play. It's the Mary Ellen Carter. I think I've played it before, but it's one of my favorite all-time songs ever, and I love Stan Rogers, and so.
Credit where credit is due. Z taught me this song.
Oh, well, thank you, Z.
Three generations of awesome. Thank you, gentlemen.
Down last October in a pouring driving rain, the skipper he'd been drinking and the mate he felt no pain. Too close to Three Mile Rock and she was dealt her mortal blow. Mary Ellen Carter settled low. She was just us five aboard her when she finally was awash. We worked like hell to save her, all heedless of the cost. The groan she gave as she went down, it caused us to proclaim that the Mary Ellen Carter would rise again, rise again, rise again, that her name would not be lost to the knowledge of men. Those who loved her best and were with her till the end will make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Wrote her off, not a nickel would they spend. She gave 20 years of service, boys, that met her sorry end. But insurance paid the loss to us, so let her rest below. They laughed at us and said we had to go. But we've talked with her all winter, some days around the clock. For she's worth a quarter million afloat and at the dock. And with every jar that hit the bar, we swore we would remain. Make Mary Ellen Carter rise again, rise again, rise again, that her name would not be lost to the knowledge of men. And those who loved her best and were with her till the end will make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Australia. wintering now. We've been with her on a barge, then by a friend. 3 dives a day in hard at suit, and twice I've had the bends. Thank God it's only 60 feet, and the currents here are slow. I'd never have the strength to go below.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no. Z.
Oh, goodness.
We've patched her ends, we've stopped her vents, dog catched and portaled down. Ever waited her fore and aft and girded her around. Tomorrow noon we hit the air and then take up the strain. Watch the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Rise again, rise again. That her name would not be lost to the knowledge men. And those who loved her best and were with her till the end will make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. We couldn't leave her there, you see, to crumble into scale. She'd saved our lives so many times, living through the gale. And the laughing drunken rats who left her to a sorry grave. Oh, they won't be laughing in another day. And you to whom adversity has dealt the final blow, with smiling bastards lying to you everywhere you go. Turn to and put out all your strength of arm and heart and brain. Like the Mary Ellen Carter, rise again, rise again. Rise again, for your heart it be broken or life about to end. No matter what you've lost, be it a home, a love, a friend. Like the Mary Ellen Carter, rise again, rise again, rise again. For your heart it be broken or life about to end. No matter what you've lost, be it a home, a love, a friend. Like the Mary Ellen Carter, rise again.
Nice.
Wow. That was outstanding.
That was lovely.
I like the way you channel. I like the way you channel Stan. It's awesome.
Well, I grew up listening to my dad say it or sing it, and he introduced me to dear old Stan, and I listened to a lot of his stuff. So, yeah.
You did that song outstanding, Robin.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. I appreciate it. That song has helped me a lot in recent times.
In a lot of times, it's helped me too.
That's awesome. Did you get your new strings?
I did. Yeah, I actually might need new strings soon.
Well, let me know. I work on Mark Taylor's boat at Portland Music Company. I can get you hooked up.
Hey, all right.
Oh. I just saw him the other day. You should. Message me. I'll give you my phone number.
Cool. Yeah. Sounds good to me.
Yeah, I got to go, you guys. I got Costco waiting for me, but I just wanted to say I love you all, and I miss you. I'm sorry I haven't been here the last couple of weeks. We've been kind of busy.
Oh, glad you're there, Fred. It's good to see Fred, look at my dog. I got a new – here's my new little puppy.
Saw your puppy. You put it on Facebook. Hold on. I got to find you. Oh, my God. It's a Jack Russell.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Those are either on or off.
Yeah, she was sleeping the whole time until now, but I don't know what's going to happen now.
I'm in my car, so I don't have a guitar with me. I'm in the Costco parking lot, so I'm going to get some stuff then. But anyway, I love all you guys. Happy 85th. And Robin, happy belated.
Yeah. Thanks, man. Thanks. And come back soon, Fred.
I will. I can't believe I got my phone to actually work. But
I'm happy you did.
Yeah. Anyway, see you guys later.
See ya.
Take care. Thanks, Steve.
Okay, who's ready for a song now? Sean, do you have one ready?
Maybe. Can you hear me? I just switched the mic.
Yeah.
Okay, I switched from my computer mic to my actual microphone, which is like $300. So.
Okay.
No.
Okay, I'm gonna mute everybody. Ready to get muted? And Sean, you're gonna unmute yourself. Yep. Okay. There we go.
That, you hear that? My little recording studio. See if I can remember this. Two more verses. I might have to look it up.
Okay, no worries.
Sending verse bytes.
So what?
The verse is coming. I know it's coming. The bytes are not working? I must dance. No?
Okay, I remember the last
one. Okay, great.
I remember the last one. My playing isn't real great because I've been playing a lot of guitar lately, but.
We disagree, by the way.
Yeah, great. Let your heart out. That's what I did. That's what I'm doing. So that is a song which is written by me.
Really?
And I have a recording somewhere, which is much better than that.
So cool! You did an original. Thank you so much, Sean.
Yeah, beautiful. Well, thanks for sharing that.
Sure.
Darcy, are you going to do
something?
Piney Woodhill, PWH, I guess it's called now.
Yeah, because, you know, everything has to have an abbreviation nowadays, right?
I think we need to
stop. I actually have a question about that because I'm not sure when that came into the corpus, but, like, if you listen to the Buffy St. Marie recordings of it, the chord progression is completely different. It's like, you know, yeah. G-E, and they don't even do through the 4-3-2 walkthrough. So I'm wondering where that arrangement came from.
I don't know. Richard,
you hear us? Who brought Pinewood Hills first? I don't even remember.
You might know. Might have even been Uzi.
Sorry, what's the question?
The question is, Pinewood Hill, where did our version come from?
Margie Stevens.
Wait, Margie Stevens? My aunt Margie Stevens?
Who
said that?
Who's the nephew of Margie?
Oh, Robin. Is Margie Stevens your aunt?
Margie Stevens, born and raised in Portland.
Yep.
She's your aunt?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. She was one of our unit mates.
Ed Stevens and Henry Stevens?
Robin, I worked with her one summer in the kitchen. I was a pantry girl. She was the pack out girl.
And she is a beautiful singer, and I wish she would come out here and sing, I don't know, Farewell to Tarwathi or something like that.
Oh my gosh, she was in our unit, and of course, we're all the age of your mother, Robin, you know that. I mean, the women
Robin, are you your own grandpa?
That's amazing.
Hey, what was Richard's question? I didn't hear that.
I asked Robin if he's his own grandpa.
Oh.
So, yeah, I listened to the Buffy St. Marie one, and it's not at all the same arrangement, which is interesting.
I don't think I've ever heard
she wrote it. I'm just sort of wondering where we got it.
Yeah. Margie.
I like the Northwestern one better than the Buffy St. Marie one, actually.
Well, I was going to say
pretty much all the Northwestern versions of songs are better than what you hear in the original.
See?
Oh, yeah.
I think that the Norwester repertory is like a unique thing. It's like a pocket of, a certain language where people have gone to a certain place and they've spoken their language, and the original country, the language has completely evolved differently. And so I think that some of the Norwester versions of songs are like the only version that's like that in the panoply of folk songs. Yeah.
Moment by moment over the summers. Yeah, it's pretty great. We have our own weird little subculture. It's so fun.
Well, and that's how folk music is, right? It changes over time.
It's like folk music, right?
One person to the next, and it changes with each singer. So
we have our own oral history, and we're all a part of it.
There you go.
All right, Darcy.
I'll play it if you want.
Okay, I'm muting everyone.
Carla.
All right. And I think I learned this from Rich. Must have. I'm a rambler and a rover and a drifter, it seems. I've traveled all over, chasing after my dreams, and a dream should come true, that a heart should be filled, and a life should be lived on a piney wood hill. I was raised on a song there. I've done right, I've done wrong there. return to the woodlands. I'll return to the hills, no. I'll return to the hills and the valleys below. I'll return as a poor girl. For a queen if God wills, but I'm on my way home to them piney wood hills. I was raised on a song there. I've done right, I've done wrong there, and it's true I belong there. It's true, it's my home, from ocean to ocean. I've rambled and roamed, and now I'll return to my piney wood home. Maybe someday I'll find someone who will love as I love those piney wood hills. I was raised on a song there. I've done right, I've done wrong there, and it's true I belong there. It's true, it's my home. Oops. Oh, da 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 da.
Thank you.
So yes, it was. It has a very wonderful new meaning for me now, since I'm actually finally moving back to my piney wood hills. So I don't know if you knew that, Rich. I'm moving to Orcas.
You're gonna be our neighbor, Rich. I'm so excited.
We're gonna be
socially distant walking a lot.
Yeah. Socially distant Mount Constitution climbs and turtleback.
Yeah.
Climbing.
Yeah.
Can't wait to find you up there, Darcy. Oh,
thank you. I'm so excited.
More camp folks on Orcas. Yay. I'm so great.
Yeah, I emailed Z and said that we're going to have an Orcas gathering or sing along or something, old camp folks sing along when COVID lets up. That would be fun.
Yeah. We could do it now 20 feet apart, but it's just not the same.
Yeah.
Huge campfire pit.
You and me can do it as we walk in the forest, Darce.
That's good.
Diane, would you like to do Carry It On?
Oh, yes.
Has it been done in a while?
Not for a while.
Great. No, we'd love to hear it.
Okay. So, you were talking about the Camp Norwester versions of songs, and I had only ever heard the Camp Norwester version, but then I went back and found Joan Baez's version, and it has a verse in it that we don't sing at Norwester, but I'm going to sneak it in.
There's like five verses, Diane, that we don't sing at Norwester. There's a bunch of them.
Why are they not included? Just because, you know?
I don't know. Again, I don't know who brought Carry It On to camp. Rich might know that, but
pretty sure that was you, Z.
Do all the political ones.
Huh. Okay. So I'm gonna do a quick
I'm unmuting everyone and mute. Oh, Diane, sorry, I muted you. Unmute. Diane, you're going to have to unmute yourself. Thanks.
Okay, I'm unmuted.
Yep.
And then you can hear me tuning. Seems to be our favorite song today. Okay. No guarantees, but here we go. There's a man. There's a voice within me talking. There's a word that needs a saying. Carry it on, carry it on. They will tell their empty stories, send their dogs to bite our bodies. They will lock us up in prison. Carry it on, carry it on. If you can't go on any longer, take the hand held by your brother. Every victory's gonna bring carry it on, carry it on. There's a man by my side walking. There's a voice within me talking. There's a word that needs a saying. Carry it on, carry it on. Carla, can we unmute everyone and have everyone sing Carry It On? Because we all need to carry it on. I'll do the verse and then join me.
Okay.
There's a man by my side walking. There's a voice within me talking. There's a word that needs a saying.
Carry it on, carry it on, carry it on, carry it on. Yay!
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And we are. Look at us doing that.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah.
Thank you, Diane. That was really wonderful.
Got another Aww. One? Z, you look ready. You have that I'm ready look. Do you have something, Z?
I could do a short song kind of for Bill and Marty. How's that? Ah,
yay. Yeah, but where'd they go?
Are they still there?
I don't see them.
To have dropped off your dad was having trouble with his goggle thing.
Oh, okay. Well, go ahead and do it anyway, Z. They can listen to the recording.
There you
yeah.
go.
Yeah.
I'm going to mute everyone now.
This is, yeah.
And Z, you can unmute yourself, please.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah. I bet. My guess is this was definitely one from Henderson Camps, and I'm not sure it's, Robin will have to tell me whether it's in current vogue. My guess is maybe not. A youth sat thinking all the day through, thinking what he should do. Whose heart to take, whose heart not to break, whose heart to break, whose heart not to take. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbala like a tumbala, tumbala, tumbala laika, tumbala laika, spielbala laika, tumbala laika, freilich so sein. Maiden, maiden, tell me true, what can grow, grow without dew? What can burn through years and years? What can cry, cry without tears? Tumbala, tumbala, tumbala laika. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbala laika. Tumbala laika, spielbala laika. Tumbala laika, freilich so sein. Oh, silly youth, I'll tell you true. Stone can grow, grow without dew. Love can burn through years and years. Heart can cry, cry without tears. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbala laika. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbala laika. Tumbala laika, spielbala laika. Tumbala laika, freilich so sein.
Thank you, Z. So
wow, I haven't heard that one in ages. I love that song.
Yeah. That is
such a beautiful song. Thank you so much, Z.
You're welcome. Yeah.
That was great.
We still sing that one. We still do.
Oh, do.
Yeah.
All right.
We still have it.
Like that, or is it morphed?
Huh? We sing it pretty much like pretty that. Much exactly like that.
That's right. So cool. I love hearing that. I really do.
Yeah, I'm so glad to hear that, Robin, because whenever I've been up there, I've missed that song. I haven't overlapped with it, so that's great to hear.
That was beautiful.
Someone hand wrote it into my book in Yiddish also.
Wow.
Wow.
That's so cool.
I don't recognize the handwriting. It's not my sister's. I can't pronounce it, so I'm not going to try it. It
looks a little bit like Lori handwriting. I don't know.
No, it looks maybe a little bit European. It's got the curled H's and whatnot. Maybe someone who is visiting camp.
Maybe. Yiddish is pretty close to German.
Yeah, and those words are all directly translatable into German.
Yeah.
Probably came from there. Who's got another one? Who wants to lay something joyful on us?
Okay, I have one. I have one that I've been working on, and I'm a bit, you know, nervous to do it, but I vowed I would do it when Z was there, because I was really nervous about that. But it's another Gordon Bach song. It's the Brandy Tree, which is the song that Gordon Bach wrote, or that actually an otter taught to Gordon Bach, apparently. And so... Of course, we were all really influenced by Gordon Bach from Tim, from Z, from Richard, and everything. So I'm going to dare to do this song, okay?
You just heard.
I hope I can do it justice. I'm going to mute you. There we go. Mute.
To the middle.
that night. But the seal don't try to tell me how to fish in the windy blue. Seal's been fishing about a thousand years, and he knows that I have to.
Corona guitar, you know.
Amazing. Well,
Corona
done.
Dog, Corona guitar.
That's one of my favorite is.
Hmm?
That's one of my favorite of his.
Oh wow!
I know. So I was singing along all because I know all the words. Did all I tell you that he played in my living room?
Oh. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was your dad that got me onto that song.
Yeah, that was like mid-70s stuff he was doing.
Mm-hmm.
Hi, Shema. Shema.
That was on San Juan, wasn't it, Sean?
Yeah, like 85, I think. We brought him from 84 or 85, we brought him from, he came out to Friday Harbor and did a concert, which Tim set up.
Who is ready to do another song?
I see some people wielding guitars in a suspicious manner. Some excellent
guitars. Yeah,
okay. Looks like he's ready.
Okay, I'm muting everybody, and the person who's going to sing, I guess it's Richard. He looks like he's got a G chord formed there. So we'll unmute himself.
All my life's a circle, sunrise and sundown. The moon rolls through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle, I can't tell you why. Seasons spinning round again, the years keep rolling. It seems like I've been here before, I can't remember when. But I've got this funny feeling that I'll be back once again. There's no straight lines make up my life, and all my roads have bends. There's no clear-cut beginnings, and so far no dead ends. All my life's a circle, sunrise and sundown. Moon rolls through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle, but I can't tell you why. The season's spinning round again, the years keep rolling. I've found you a thousand times, I guess you've done the same. But then we lose each other, it's just like a children's game. But as I see you here again, a thought runs through my mind. Our love is like a circle, let's go round one more time. All my life's a circle, sunrise and sundown. The moon rolls through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle, but I can't tell you why. The season's spinning round again, the years keep rolling.
Thank you so much. Oh. I'm so glad you did that, Rich. Man. It's in a horrible key for me, and I've never figured out a better key for it, so I'm glad that you
thank you so much,
Rich. Yeah, well, I got to the point where I couldn't sing it very well in C, so I had to relocate it.
Were you in a different key, or did you just capo it? I couldn't tell.
I played it in G, and I capoed it a couple, three. So, yeah, it's a different key. No, it's closer to A. Like, what did I put it in? Z? A sharp?
B.
B, okay.
Okay.
No.
Yeah. Nobody plays in B. Right. That's what capos are for. Yep.
We love that.
The beautiful song.
Oh, yeah. Who wrote it, Rich?
That's a Harry Chapin song.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Darcy, your arm is over your guitar. Does that mean you're going to...
Well, so I was thinking about when a scene Z that made me think about it. You probably don't remember this Z, but when, you know, I said before, you were my first guitar teacher at camp. And one of the first time I played Musicale, it was Karen Holm and I played a song called Julianne that you sang. You taught us. And we were like nine and played Musicale for the first time. And so I just ran across it in the songbook, but I haven't played it in years and I don't remember it. So I'm going to try to get that one for next week. But that was what was running across my mind. But then I just opened up to Carolina in my mind. I don't know if anybody wants to hear something.
Oh, you know we do.
Okay.
Well, here I go. I'm muting you all now.
Bye.
All right. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel?
soft and kind. Hey, babe, the sky's on fire, I'm dying, ain't I? Gone to Carolina in my mind. 'Cause in my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it just like a friend of mine hitting me from behind? And I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Dark and silent late last night, I think I might have heard the highway call.
Oops.
Deep in flapping dogs that bite. Signs that might be omens, say I'm going, going, gone to Carolina in my mind. 'Cause in my mind, I'm going to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it just like a friend of mine hitting me from behind? And I'm going to Carolina in my mind.
We used to sing Going to Camp Norwester in my mind, but it's been a long time.
I miss hearing your voice, Darcy.
Thank you, Rich. I miss hearing yours.
This is so awesome.
Reunion, and or I'll come over to Lopez sometime and we can play. I would love that.
Z, I saw you with your guitar a few minutes ago. Do you want to play another song?
I think I've done mine.
Well, it's,
Robin, you want to not do another youngster. One?
I mean, I have a song ready.
Okay.
Shocked.
Okay. Go. No. Great.
Take off.
Okay.
It was good to see you,
Fred. Thanks, Sean. Or Fred. Who said that?
That's
Fred.
That's Sean. That was Fred. Or Sean. Oh.
Sean. We're all getting mixed up. Thanks so much for coming.
Happy Fred as well.
Really nice right. to see you.
Yeah, I'll drop by again if I can.
Please but, you know, do, this, yeah.
Special occasion, so. Okay. Happy
Fortress Rock Fire.
Fortress Rock Fire.
Okay, I'm going to mute all and Robin's going to unmute.
All right. Well, this is kind of a happy song. It's a love song. So, you know, those are, depends on your state of mind. It can be happy. It can be not. So. But yeah, I love this song. One of my friends at camp taught it to me a while ago. A while ago. The first day of my life, it's where I was born, right in the doorway. When out in the rain, suddenly everything changed. They're spreading blankets on the beach. Yours was the first face that I saw. I think I was blind before I met you. Don't know where I am, don't know where I've been, but I know where I want to go. So I thought I'd let you know that these things take forever. I especially am slow, but I realized that I need you, and I wondered if I could come home. Remember the time you drove all night,
just to meet me in the morning. I thought it was strange, you said everything changed. You felt as if you just woke up. You said, this is the first day of my life. Glad I didn't die before I met you. No, I don't care, I could go anywhere with you, and I'd probably be happy. So if you wanna be with me, with these things there's no telling, we just have to wait and see. But I'd rather be working for a paycheck than waiting to win the lottery. Besides, maybe this time it's different. I mean, I really think you like me.
Robin, who wrote that?
That is
not tallest man on earth.
It's not the tallest man on earth, actually.
But it sounds like God. Why am I not getting the name now? Who wrote Operator?
Jim Croce.
Jim Croce. It sounds like Croce.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Fred's back.
So, Robin, ask me why I know it's not the tallest man on earth.
Why do you know it's not the tallest man on earth?
Because of you, I went and bought all his albums.
Yes. Good. I converted another person.
I am now cooler than I was because I know you, Robin. So thank you.
Wait, tallest man on earth is a person?
Yeah, he's an artist.
Great. You should look up, because Robin says his music is awesome, and you've heard Robin sing some of his music.
Okay.
Jimmy Dean.
My socially distant walking partner is here to socially distantly walk in the forest, so I must go. I love you all madly. Thank you so much. See you next week.
Is that Janet?
That is Janet. Janet and I walk every Sunday.
Okay, Corey, but you're going to miss Julie playing The Golden Day is Dying on the flute.
Sorry, but she's here. I must go. And it's
okay. Well, you sing along from afar. Social distance singing from afar.
Indeed.
Bye, Corey.
Bye, Corey.
Yeah, Megan is right. It's by an artist called Bright Eyes.
Oh.
Yeah.
That was beautiful, Robin. Thank you.
Yeah,
it was stunning. Elizabeth. Absolutely stunning.
Do you do the Wild Hunt as well, Robin?
Oh.
Man on Earth.
I have wanted to learn how to play that song for ages.
I'll have to get my son to teach us both.
Yeah.
He does it.
Because I love that song. There's so many songs of his that he uses so many different tunings.
Yeah.
That, like, most of them I've just had to figure out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Like, I can play Love Is All. I can play Little River. I can play Little Brother, I think. There's a few of his that I can play, but it's taken me a bit.
All right. Well, good. Glad to think of it again.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
We'll be looking forward to more in the coming weeks.
There you go.
So the Wild Hunt, this is your chance to start learning it. Is that what it was called? Yeah. The Wild Hunt? Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah,
I'll have to start listening to it again. Uh-huh. It's a really good song.
Long.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. It is not a simple song. That's for sure.
All right.
So did I hear that Julie's going to play Golden Day is Dying?
On the flute, yes.
Yeah, and as our last song.
Are we ready for our last song?
Well, I'm going to have to leave pretty soon, but...
Yeah, my dog wants a walk as well.
Yeah, and my dog
he wanted you to play Golden Day.
So the impetus of this is that I can play the flute a little bit, but I have to read music. And many people who play the flute can just play it, but I can't do that. So I'm trying to learn how to do that. And so I learned this song because it's pretty easy, and we'll see if I can play it. I have no music anywhere, and we'll see if I can do it. And I want you all to sing along. And for those of you who don't know the words, it's very easy. The golden day is dying beyond the purple hills, the lark that sang at morning in dusty wooded still. That's verse number one. But soon above the meadow, the silver moon will swing. But soon above the meadow, the silver moon will swing. And where the wood is darkest, the varied thrush will sing. Do that twice. So just a few times through, and we'll see if I can get through with that. I will probably make mistakes, but.
Julie, would you like us to mute everyone? And
and you can all just sing along.
No,
yeah.
We'll mute and we'll sing along, and we could see if we want to unmute for a last chorus or something. Okay, everyone get ready to mute. And then Julie, unmute. Can you unmute yourself, Julie?
Okay. Are you unmuting?
Nice.
Okay, are you unmuting? Okay, last verse, everybody sing along.
Above the meadow, the silver moon will swing.
But when the moon is darkest,
a varied thrush will swing.
Well,
that's really
nice, everybody.
Let me go. Unhand me.
This dog is having a tantrum. If I let her go, she's gonna attack my feet. Eddie, calm down.
Julie,
that was beautiful. Yeah, Julie, good job.
Yeah, not too many mistakes.
That's
I'm
good.
Learning.
That's,
it was beautiful. And the way
remember,
to learn
Julie,
how to
the one
do
you
that,
don't perform
Julie,
is the one
to do
the
it a lot.
Yep.
Just to do it a lot. Play all the songs that you can think of. Play whatever comes to your mind. I was in the same position for years because I played flute too, and I learned to read music on the flute. And it just takes a long time to just get away from the page, but you can do it. Just have fun.
Yeah. Yep. All right, I'm gonna go walk my dog, everybody.
Me too.
Glorious week, and we'll see you next week.
See you.
Bye, everybody.
Thanks
Bye,
for coming, everyone. Really great to see you. And
wonderful to see you all.
Happy Fortress Rock Conflagration Day.
Yeah.
Many years have come and gone all since that fateful day.
My mother's
birthday. Bye-bye. Thanks a lot.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Good to see you all.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Fred. Fred, what's that mask? All right.
Come at a hardware store. Sing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Northwestern Musicale in a hardware store.
I didn't want to miss anything. I took you with me.
All right.
I'm fogging.
Oh, I'm glad, Alex, there. I'm glad you came. Yeah, Fred, I'll see you hopefully next time. Will you come next time?
Maybe. Absolutely.
Okay.
Take care, you guys.
If you got a song, that'd be great. Bye. Alex, nice to see you. I'm really glad you made it. And thank you could do a song you. Next time, too. This was
if
a great
I get
one.
My lap. If I get my laptop back, I can do that. This has been weird over the phone, but thank you, everybody. It's been a delight.
And the sound is good on your phone. Okay, I'm going to end the meeting now.
Okay.
Love to you all. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Wait, it's not ending. It will end. Okay, bye, Fred.